St. Patrick's Day to you that are have some Irish in you. As we study this message on Zacchaeus, we've probably all heard it before and know how Zacchaeus was trying to get a glimpse of Jesus. Isn't that kind of how it is for us when we go somewhere? We need that visual aid. Well, for me, as short as I am, I can really relate to this Zacchaeus climbing a tree. But as we start, I want the people that are into geography to realize where we are at when we talk about Jericho. Jericho is one of the ancient cities, and it was about 17 miles from Jerusalem. So Jesus and his disciples are walking a wandering path, and they're 17 miles from Jerusalem at this time. The city of Jericho is 5 miles west of the Jordan River and 10 miles northwest of the Dead Sea. I don't know if any of you have been to the Middle East and been to Jerusalem, but you can probably get a good feel as to where this at, whether you've been there or not. So Zacchaeus, he was a rich tax collector. Now, I'm thinking to myself, why was that mentioned in the Bible? Why was that printed that he was rich? And what difference did his profession make? But there was a purpose for that. And he was rich because he had taken advantage of people with his tax collection business. He was an overseer of the tax collectors. The tax that they collected was for the Roman government. Zacchaeus himself was a Jew, but yet he was working for the Romans. So you can see how he might have fit in with the other Jews. They probably kind of looked on him in a way of disappointment. And then to see him do so well financially, that may have kind of rubbed him wrong also. In verse 3, we see that Zacchaeus is trying to see Jesus. He has heard, like everyone, of Jesus and the miracles he has performed. And he's also looking for Jesus for hope and curiosity at this point. He's curious. As the streets are lined up, he can't find a place to stand or he's going to get a glimpse of anybody as they come by. So he sees the route that Jesus and the disciples are on, and he sees a sycamore tree. I didn't know what a sycamore tree was. I thought, what's that, like a cedar tree? And he's climbing in a cedar tree? But what I got out of my study Bible was a sycamore tree grows to be 30 to 40 feet tall. It has lateral branches that can support the weight of a man. And some of the branches are low enough that it wouldn't be difficult to climb into this tree. So well-suited for a short man trying to get up where he can see what's coming along on the road. As Jesus and the disciples and other followers come along, they come to this tree where Zacchaeus is. My thought is, maybe this is wrong, but I'm thinking Zacchaeus feels guilty of his sin. And in a way, he's kind of trying to hide in this tree. But yet, he's still wanting to see Jesus. Well, Jesus comes along, and he stops at the tree. And he looks up in the tree, and he says, Zacchaeus, you come down. You come down in a hurry, we're going to your house tonight. So here comes Zacchaeus. He comes hustling out of this tree. He's looking around over his shoulder, see if anybody's paying attention. And they are. And they're grumbling. The bystanders are grumbling and they're saying, Jesus is going off with another sinner. Why are they going to his house? You know, they're judging Jesus' decision and they're judging Zacchaeus. We're no different than them. We do the same thing. Anyway, they go off to Zacchaeus' house. I'm thinking Zacchaeus probably has a family. There's probably others at his house. Here comes the disciples of Jesus. And it is great that they welcomed and came in and spent time. And as they do so, we don't know the small conversations that went on, but the Bible states in verse 8 of Luke 19 that Zacchaeus stood up. I'm assuming they're probably sitting. Well, he stands up. And he speaks to Jesus and calls him Lord. Well, that's a major step right there. He's recognizing Jesus as Lord. And then he goes on to say that he is going to give half of his goods to the poor, and he's going to give fourfold to those that he has taken from in the wrong way. And Jesus knows right then and there that Zacchaeus has changed his gods. He's leaving this god of money and wealth, and he's looking for a savior. And so Jesus makes the statement. Let me get it here exactly. Today, salvation has come to this house because he also is a son of Abraham. So Jesus realizes the things that have changed in the priorities of Zacchaeus. And being it says salvation has come to this house, I'm assuming the wife, the children, others are being supporters of Zacchaeus' commitments and are following in the same for salvation and the good of mankind in general. Then Jesus states, the Son of Man has come to seek and to save that which was lost. So all along, we're thinking that Zacchaeus was searching for Jesus. Jesus was searching for Zacchaeus. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, as we think of this time of the year, we think of all the sin and guilt that we place on you, Jesus, as you hung from the cross. You bore it all, and you continue to bear it all. Dear Heavenly Father, have mercy on us sinners. We need to focus on salvation and saving the lost. Dear God, a couple years ago I gave a message on the sheep, and we are like sheep. We're straying and we are needing gathered up by Christ our Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen.